The word you're looking for here is obsessed. Today we're talking about 1984's Footloose. Footloose is the story of Ren McCormick, a rebel from Chicago, who moves to Beaumont, Tennessee, I think. And no dancing is allowed in the town. And he loves to dance. So that's problem number one. Problem number two, Reverend's daughter is a rebel and a babe. Even though I don't think so, but she wears red cowboy boots really well, so go her. But whatever. Anyway, he's in love with her. She's got a boyfriend. They do a tractor thing, chicken, game. Yeah. And that's wild. Ren wins. Ultimately, they have a prom. Footloose is just one of those movies that I love because I love it. Dancing, 80s, Kevin Bacon, hair, a beautiful display of punch dancing and wife beaters that has never before been seen in film and never again will be because you can't recreate that. It's brilliant. It makes me feel good. It makes me happy. I like watching it. And more than that, I watched it once with the commentary and Kevin Bacon liked making it. And that is what counts, you know? A lot of people would regret a move like that, doing a movie about dancing, wearing their hair in the fashion he did, almost as if he was electrocuted 24/7. But Kevin enjoyed it, and he loved working with the people he worked with. And that is just really what is the best part about Footloose, is that they had fun making it, it's a fun movie to watch, you can't not dance to the soundtrack, every single song is quality. It is perfect. It's wonderful. I love it. I just love Footloose. I can't help myself. When they remade it, I got so pissed. Everybody's like, did you see the remake? No. I have some respect and dignity, okay? I only need Kevin Bacon as Ren McCormick in my life, not this young punk whomever he is. And Dennis Quaid as John Lithgow. Give me a break, all right? I just love watching Kevin Bacon dance. It is so attractive. And he's attractive enough to me in the first place, so it's just adding a whole nother level of just, you know, dreamy actions. It's just so adorable when Ren is teaching his hillbilly friend, whose name I can't remember, how to dance. It's so cute because he actually, as Kevin said in the commentary, was not much of a dancer. And so it was real, but it was film. To add credibility to this film, it was based on actual events that took place in Elmore City, Oklahoma, because they banned dancing and rock music in their town. I don't know if it was after the Reverend's son died from drunk driving and drove off a bridge, but ultimately, that it's a thing that happened. So it's real. It's a quality film. Highly credible. Worth every second. Ultimately, it's just a great movie about growing up and being a teenager in a town that you just can't dance in. You're being restricted and taken not seriously by your conservative relatives that get rocks thrown through their windows because you're a pain in the ass. Kevin Bacon. This is true. Watch his interview on Conan. Pays DJs not to play Footloose at weddings. poor man. What a wonderful song ruined for him.
They had put a fart machine into my sleeping bag.